Hi guys, welcome to Shields Cooking. Today we're going to make a beautiful dish made from homemade gyoza with mushrooms and silent tea. It's a little bit different than what I usually do, but it's going to be delicious. So, let's begin.
Start by chopping 500 grams of mushrooms. Now heat up a pan, add a splash of oil and bake the mushrooms golden brown. Meanwhile, clean 4 onions and then chop them. Do this as well with half a celeriac. Add to the baked mushrooms together with 3 sprigs of thyme and then cover it completely with water. Let it simmer for 2 hours. Now take the pan off the heat and add 3 tablespoons of silent tea. Let this marinate for 5 minutes and then put it through a sieve. Use a ladle to press all the liquid out so you don't waste anything. Then cut 1 lime in half and add the juice to the broth. Now season it with salt. Then save half of the broth for later and bind the remaining broth with some santana powder. After that, cut the ends of king mushrooms and cut it in thin slices on a mandolin. Now put it on a silicone sheet and brush some dashi vinegar on top. Then lay another sheet on top and bake it at 140 degrees Celsius for around 50 minutes. Now let it cool down completely. Then cut the size of 5 king mushrooms and cut them in half. Now make a diamond pattern and then cut it in half again. Now bake them in some oil and salt till golden on both sides. Once golden, add 100 milliliters of the mushroom broth and reduce this. Now cut the trimmings in slices and chop it. Then heat up a pan and bake the mushrooms in some oil and salt till golden. After that, add 200 milliliters of the mushroom broth and reduce this. Meanwhile, cut 4 leaves of wild garlic fine and add this to the baked mushrooms. Also add the zest of 3 kumquats. Then chop 1 tablespoon of silent tea fine and add this as well. Mix this. Now transfer it into a bowl, cover it with plastic foil and let it cool down in your fridge. Then pour 250 milliliters of oil in a blender together with 2 tablespoons of silent tea. Blender this for around 10 minutes and then pour it on a sieve laid with a clean kitchen paper. Now transfer 250 grams of flour you worked up together with 2 grams of salt. Make a big hole in the middle and pour 140 grams of lukewarm water in the middle. Mix this with your fingers until it comes together and then knead it until it's a nice ball of dough. Cover it with plastic foil and then let it rest out of the fridge for 30 minutes. Meanwhile, fill a bowl with lukewarm water and add a large amount of salt. Mix this. Then wash 100 grams of morels and 100 grams of baby mushrooms. Now take the mushrooms out of the water and repeat this process 4 times. Then let them dry on a clean kitchen towel. After that, cut some thin kumquat slices with a sharp knife. Now dust your worktop with cornstarch and put your dough on top. Then divide it into pieces of 12 grams. Now roll it into a bowl and then use a rolling pin to flatten it out. Then cut it with a round cutter. Now brush a small layer of water on top and then pipe the mushroom filling in the middle. Then press the middle together and carefully fold it in 4 times to the outside. Do this on both sides. Now cut the ends with a round cutter. Then bake the baby mushrooms in a hot pan till golden, and once golden, add the morels. Season it with salt and bake it for 2 minutes. Now add a nut of butter and bake it for another 2 minutes. Then heat up a baking pan and bake the gyozas golden brown in a small layer of oil on the big side. Now turn the gyozas on the small side and add the remaining mushroom broth. Then put a lid on the pan and let the gyoza steam for 2 to 4 minutes. Now put the gyozas in a deep plate together with the baked mushrooms. Then add the thinly sliced kumquats, some watercress tops, and the king mushroom crispies. And then I serve it with the mushroom broth and the silent tea oil.
Okay guys, that's it for today. I hope you've enjoyed the video. So don't forget to like and share it, and subscribe if you want to see more. Bon appétit!